Hello everyone, my name is Ed, and today I have the honor of taking you through a tour of the residence halls, University Housing Services. Guys, it's not just a place to sleep, it's where you live. Living means roommates and floor mates and floor events. It also means a place to learn. You're gonna learn about yourself, how to live on your own. You're gonna learn how to be part of a community full of diverse individuals. You're gonna learn how to wake up on time for class without anyone else's help. University housing is a place where you'll make lifelong memories and priceless friends. So today I get to tell you about all three residence halls. Let's go. There are a lot of places to live on campus. We have three main areas. All three are about 2 to 3 songs of walking distance from any academic building. Now I always get this question. Ed, what's your favorite place to live? Where's the best place to live on campus? The truth is, it's everywhere. What makes the experience special are the people there and the services that we offer. Truly top notch. You'll love anywhere you live on campus. The first area to live on campus is Tri-Towers. Tri-Towers is great because it's close to a lot of our athletic complexes, like the football field, the Redbird Arena, the area where the marching band practices, the gym where the gymnastics cheer, and our very own circus troupe practice. Also, the hashtag views are amazing, and we have an amazing dining center over there called the Marketplace at Lincoln's. There's a Mongolian grill that you just have to experience to understand. So good. The second area of campus is Hewitt Manchester. Hewitt Manchester features our themed living and learning communities, or TLLCs, which are themed floors that allow you to live on the floor with someone else with the same major or interest as you. As well, in place of a dining center, Hewitt Manchester features the campus's tutoring center on campus. And Hewitt Manchester is open during all of our university breaks over fall, winter, and spring. So if that's something that might be appealing to you, you might like Hewitt Manchester. The final area is Watterson Towers. It's where we are right now. It's actually the tallest building between St. Louis and Chicago, and it's one of the tallest residence halls in the world. I think it's pretty cool. It also has its own connected dining center called Watterson Dining Commons, where the food is great. Move-in is a really exciting event on campus. You'll sign up for your own time to move into our residence halls, and then when you get to campus, you'll unload your belongings, take them up to your room, and enjoy. Our staff is here at all times to help you out with whatever you may need. Move-in is typically in August, and it's about a week long. And here are some things that you might want to bring. Stuff for your bed. We'll give you a bed, but you gotta dress it up yourself. So go ahead and bring any sheets, pillows, maybe your favorite blanket that you like. Also bring clothes. Don't forget those, but not all your clothes. You probably don't need like your snow pants, all your bathing suits, and all your favorite shoes, including those Crocs. Go ahead and just bring the essentials, and you can go back home to get them anytime. You also might wanna bring some things for class academics or for your desk. So highlighters, pens, pencils, notebooks, laptops, chargers, can't live without those. Lastly, you might want to bring some snacks, an eco-friendly water bottle perhaps. Oh, and a Keurig. If you can't live without your coffee like me, you're gonna need that. Here's some things you would want to leave at home. Please don't bring any appliances like blenders, toasters, or microwaves. We'll provide a microwave for you on every floor. Also, make sure not to bring anything that generates too much heat, like candles or hot plates. You don't want to bring anything that could potentially burn down our buildings. Yikes. Don't bring any hoverboards. Do people still use hoverboards? I don't know. And don't bring any drugs or alcohol. Those are not allowed in our residence halls at any time. The RA, or a resident assistant, are one of the first people you're going to want to get to know when you move in on campus. They help out with community building, which just means helping to get to know other people on your floor and make friends, policy enforcement, and can serve as an informational resource to you if you ever need anything or want to know where something is on campus. We also have 24/7 live-in professional staff members here to support you. One to know is called the RHC, or the Residence Hall Coordinator. They are master's level full-time professionals who are in charge of a residence hall building or area that they oversee. They can really help you out if you ever need anything as well. Finally, we also have what are called case managers. Sometimes you just need some one-on-one support. You know, if you're ever feeling stressed or anxious, or if you just need someone to talk to, the case managers also live in and are a great resource for you as well. Laundry services are also included for you. You can take your laundry to wherever your designated area is, and you can wash or dry as many cycles as you'd like. Finally, every residence hall area also has a computer lab where you can do any kind of schoolwork or print anything you need as well. There's some other cool things that in part of support services that you're gonna wanna know. We also have a bus system that comes to every residence hall about every 10 minutes or so called Connect Transit. You can use an app on your phone to track where the bus is going at any given time, so you can never be late for a class. If you don't know who to live with, no worries. In the Housing and Dining portal, you can look at other students' profiles to find a roommate that matches with your interests just the way you like. It's kind of like an OkCupid or a Match.com type deal. You'll love it. So to select your residence hall room, if you sign your contract and submit your initial payment by May 1st, we'll contact you over the summer to let you know exactly what date you can log into the Housing and Dining portal to select your room with your matched roommate of choice. And we'll also tell you over the summer and when your room assignment is actually finalized. There are a number of items that come in a residence hall room for you already. We'll provide a bed, a dresser, a desk with a chair, and our beds are loftable. What that means is you can raise the height higher or lower to fit your needs. So you don't need to bring any other tools with you either. We'll provide those. You can junior loft your bed, which means just raising it to its highest height as it is, and you can put storage or maybe a refrigerator or your dresser underneath to make even more space. Or you can get really creative and get what's called a lofting kit. We'll provide those for you too, free of charge. You can loft your bed up high as a bunk bed would be, and you can get even more creative by putting TVs, couches, futons, refrigerators, and other things under your bed to really make your room unique in your own. So your next steps are logging into the Housing and Dining portal. This is kind of like our website within a website, kind of like Inception in a way. So in this Housing and Dining portal, you can sign contracts, which basically just means you're committing to whatever room selection you'd like and your meal plan option. You can also submit initial payments as well as match with any potential roommates that you find interesting. That's right, you get to choose your own roommate. And you can do this as long as you sign your contract and submit your initial payment by May 1st. There's a big window of time for you to do this, so there's no rush. But if you match with a roommate and submit your payment by May 1st, you can choose the exact room type you want to live in the exact location you'd like. If you say you want to live in room 206, that room is yours and your roommate's, which is great. If you happen to not submit your contract by May 1st, no worries. Our team will help you and select a room for you by manual assignment. We do this by looking at your preferences and choosing a room and a roommate for you that matches your preferences up to a 70% match. We work long and hard on this, so we think you'll be happy with our choice. And like I said earlier, any place on campus is a great place to live. We're really excited for you to join us on campus. We hope you enjoyed the tour. Be sure to check out our housing website, housing.illinoisstate.edu, to check out more about our announcements or important updates that you'd want to know. And be sure to follow our social media. We're funny. We give out free things sometimes. You can check out 360 room views of all of our room types. And I hear there's a really cool guy with awesome hair that's in charge of the whole thing. So be sure to follow us. But anyways, even now, before you've even moved into your room, our staff is always here for you. We'd be so happy if you reached out to us. And with that, the housing tour is over. Go Redbirds! Later!